What's up, everybody? Derek Anderson, the DA, and man, look at that headline right there, boy. I tell you, that headline hurts. That hurts because I think that Andor absolutely is the best thing that Star Wars has done, at least in the Disney era, okay? Since Disney has took over, I hands down believe that this is the best thing that they've done, and I love The Mandalorian, at least the first season. Second season's okay, but this is so far, in my opinion, the best thing that Star Wars has done since Disney has taken over, and it's the least popular, man. It's like, God damn, man, why did they? And I know why it's the least popular, okay? I know why it's the least popular, because they've absolutely scared off every Star Wars fan that actually would have given a damn about this type of a series, okay? They tried to appeal to the nostalgic guys. Oh, don't you like, you know, the Jedis, and don't you like the droids, and don't you like this ship, that ship? And they tried to push all of the nostalgia, but they never built, like, actual shows or actual characters, with the exception of The Mandalorian. Everything else is nostalgia bait, it seems like. All of that stuff with Book of Boba Fett, all of that stuff with Obi-Wan, total nostalgia bait, all right? And the stuff that people actually would have loved, like that they really were looking for, they just never did. Then they also tried to go the identity politics route. Oh yeah, let's go ahead and change this thing up and talk about identity politics and win the hearts and minds of social justice warriors. Instead of just telling stories that people can really get into, stuff that means something to the actual fans. So yeah, that's one of the biggest reasons why this thing is not as popular as it should be. Let's go ahead and check out this article. So it says, the 3-episode premiere of Andor trailed other Star Wars shows in viewership per Nielsen. It's also underperforming in audience demand according to Parrot Analytics, but the show is the best reviewed Star Wars series yet. Absolutely, all of that is 100% true. It says here that Andor has a critic score of 95% on Rotten Tomatoes through its first 7 of 12 episodes. The Mandalorian had an 893 average score for its first 2 seasons. Obi-Wan received an 82 and Book of Boba Fett a middling 66. I don't even know how that Book of Boba Fett got 66. That thing just feels like a 50, 40, 30, somewhere up in that range. But its popularity doesn't quite reflect its quality compared to those other series. And I want you guys to see this, okay? Because it's not just the critics, okay? The audiences are actually liking it. Those that have watched it, okay? Which clearly is not very many folks, comparatively speaking. It's doing fine, okay? 83%, 95%, you know, people should be watching this show and talking about it. Yeah, is it slow burn? It is slow burn, okay? Is it going to be for every Star Wars fan out there? Of course not. But like I said, they've kind of, in my opinion, dumbed down the level of quality for Star Wars. You know, this is what happens when you pander to an agenda and you try to push a lot of stuff into a series. You kind of dumb down your audience, okay? Because now your audience is just expecting bright, shiny colors. You know, hey, man, where's the lightsabers at? You know, there was deeper storytelling always in Star Wars. It was rare, right, that the lightsabers got whipped out in the original trilogy, okay? You know, we were getting story in the original trilogy, all right? And, you know, Empire Strikes Back. I mean, you don't see that much lightsaber action in that, right? But then by the time you get to the prequels, it's like lightsabers are all over the place. And then, of course, they brought that out in the sequel trilogy with people that are completely untrained with lightsabers, but they're whipping them out and they're defeating people that have been trained for years and years. It's just unbelievable how poorly they conceived this thing from the beginning. And what frustrates me is this. Now, this is on StarWarsNewsNet.com. And it's talking about basically how Andor is underperforming. It says 6 episodes into Andor, we still don't have a full grasp of how the series is performing with audiences. While critic reactions were strong following the premiere, and overall the series seems to be well accepted amongst the fan base, it's hard to quantify that sensation. However, new data from Parrot Analytics shows that Andor is not as in demand with respect to everything else that is streaming today as previous shows like The Mandalorian were. And it gives you this little chart. Now I'm going to bring this up, blow it up a little bit. So let's go in order here. So you got this little purple line right here. That represents Mando season 2, all right? The red line, this red line here that you see represents Mando season 1. Then you got the Book of Boba Fett. That's the orange line. The green line right here is Obi-Wan. And then way over here is this purple line. You say, well, where's that? Yeah, that's this line down here at the bottom, and that's Andor, okay? Now, the good news here is that season 2 is already a go. They're going to produce season 2. It's already in the books as far as coming out, okay? So they're not going to, like, not make season 2 because of this type of performance. But what will happen is, you already know this, right? That Disney, stupid as they are going to come back, oh, well, I guess nobody likes these types of shows. shows. Let's go ahead and make Book of Boba Fett again. Let's do this kind of crap that we were doing with these two. Mandalorian's going to be fine because that's helmed by really good writers and directors. Jon Favreau, Dave Filoni, they know what they're doing. Okay? But these two crappy shows, we're going to get more of this and less of this because of how much better these perform. They'll say, all right, yeah, this is the floor right here. Okay? This is the floor that we want. We wanted to stay around here. Yeah, unfortunately, Andor didn't make it. So we're not going to see anything else like Andor, okay? I guarantee it because, you know, the people at Disney are stupid, okay? But this all started because of Disney from the very beginning. And now what you're going to get is more nostalgia bait. Basically, that's all this stuff represents right here. Boba Fett and Obi-Wan just represent a whole bunch of nostalgia. So get ready for, all right, well, Andor didn't work. Let's go ahead and get an Ewok show out there. Let's go ahead and get a C-3PO trilogy. Let's start doing all the nostalgia stuff because that's all Star Wars fans are going to appeal to anyway. No, you built the fan base this way by promoting all of that stuff the entire time since you've had it. You haven't actually struck out and tried to do something original with the exception of The Mandalorian and now Andor. And it's probably too little too late. If Andor came out 3 or 4 years ago before you pissed everybody off, I guarantee you that Andor would have been doing a lot better. Honestly, man, like, for me, all I wanted to see out of Star Wars, I wanted to see two types of shows. I wanted to see a bounty hunter, like smugglers, you know, criminal underworld, criminal syndicates. I wanted to see that type of a show. And I guess they tried to give that to us in Book of Boba Fett. Absolutely trash. Didn't work at all. They didn't get a really good writer to write that thing out, okay? And then I wanted to see a different show, something about just like the common people of the world and just their day-to-day stuff. I didn't know how they were going to put it together, but they did that with Andor, okay? You got rebels going about their rebel business, trying to not just going on the mission, but the whole planning and plotting of the mission. How are we going to get money for the mission? Okay, we got to steal money from this particular bank. We got to rob it, okay? So this is what we got to do. Just planning that mission out, okay? It's not just bust in there and then the tension and the drama that leads up to it. You know, who can you trust? Who can't you trust? You know, even from the Senate standpoint where we see Mon Mothma and everything that Mon Mothma is dealing with, you know, trying to fund this rebellion covertly and not get found out and basically sent off to the gulags or whatever, all right? You got Mon Mothma in that mode. And then like Luthen, right? Luthen like pretending to run some kind of curio shop, like he's a shopkeeper, you know, that's dealing with all these rare little things. You know, he's just putting up this front, but he's really running the rebellion from the shadows. And I'm loving that stuff, right? And then you got like even the Imperials, right? And what's going on behind the scenes? And how, hey man, how are we going to catch these rebels? What's going on here? You got different like rivalries that's going on between Imperial, you know, officers and this ISB, this security bureau that's like a CIA. And I mean, it's like, this is dope, man. This is the kind of stuff they should have been doing all along. Not this Book of Boba Fett crap, man. Get that crap out of here. Man, and they finally figure it out and it might be too late. So Slash Film says, Andor is the best live action Star Wars show, so why the heck aren't people watching? Well, we already just talked about that. There's a lot of problems, of course, starts with that damn Lucasfilm story group and all the nonsense that they wanted to push out there. They did update this. They said that the new reporting showed that Andor was doing a little bit better than what they initially had reported. So that's nice, but it's still not doing as good as these other two right here, okay? It's still not doing as good as these two. So unfortunately, that means that Disney's just going to double down on the BS and give their reasons, right? Have we reached an era of Star Wars fatigue? Well, yeah, there is Star Wars fatigue because people got tired of your shit, okay? They got tired of you not listening to the fans, right? That's what they got tired of, right? Thank God for guys like Dwayne The Rock Johnson to say, hey, man, we gonna listen to the fans. As opposed to the idiots over there at Rings of Power. Oh, no, we're not listening to the fans. We won't listen to the fans at all. Why? Why? Because you're a bunch of mental fucking midgets. That's why you won't listen to the fans. Okay, the fans are your goddamn customers. You're supposed to listen to them. So yeah, Star Wars fell into the same trap. Oh, we're just going to make stuff for ourselves. We're not going to listen to the actual fan base that buys our tickets, that pays our salaries. We're not going to listen to those guys. And we're going to try to engender this brand new fan base. And this, guess what this brand new fan base isn't doing, okay? All of these people that you're trying to cater to, guess what they're not doing? They're not watching Andor. Shit. And then they try to say, oh, well, you know, it has a tough quality genre TV competition. No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. Okay. This is Star Wars. What are you talking about? This is Star Wars. Of all the genres that should be knocking it out of the park, it should be Star Wars. Okay. I get it. Marvel's better right now in terms of their popularity. So I understand that, okay? I understand that you have the Lord of the Rings that you're going up against with Rings of Power. I understand House of the Dragon. You're going up against that. But damn it, this is Star Wars. Star Wars should not be coming in fourth. I'm sorry. That's just my personal opinion. But again, you know, I told you guys, up on Star Wars Hill, that's where you're going to find my dead body. I'm going to die on that son of a bitch. This is ridiculous. I don't want to hear that they're going up against tough competition. You guys screwed this up, Lucasfilm, from the very beginning. Okay. Is it too little, too late? I sure as hell hope not. But this right here, I'm telling you, this doesn't give me a lot of confidence. This does not give me a lot of confidence. And frankly, neither does this. Now, these are the numbers that they said, yeah, we're going to have to change that up. It wasn't quite as accurate as they should be. So they're going to change up that Andor, but it came in six, you know, and that still isn't good enough, man. For me, it's not good enough. But anyway, folks, what do you think about Andor? Is it too little, too late? Is it too little, too late for Star Wars? I mean, it's doing good right here. This tells another story 100%. And man, this really tells a story. This is the one I'm afraid of the most because they're just going to revert to making this type of crap. But go ahead, guys. Leave me your thoughts and your opinions in the comments below. And thanks for watching. See you next time.